your hope you are fine and safe at home. Today we are going to learn lesson number 3. The name of the lesson is A Mean Deal. Repeat after me, children. A mean deal. Here deal means distributing or dividing. So in this lesson we are going to learn about the importance of 3 meals in the morning, in the afternoon and in the night. So we are going to learn the importance of 3 meals in this lesson, a meal deal. First, let us see an interesting activity.
Children, now we are going to see an interesting activity of healthy food and fast food. It is also called as junk food. These junk foods are unhealthy for our health. Children, see the healthy foods. These are healthy foods. Vegetables, fruits, water and fruit juices. These things are healthy foods. These foods gives us energy and these foods gives us healthy and it will make us energy. So we have to eat healthy foods more. Okay, see this: vegetables, fruits, water, juices. These are healthy foods. Now look at the unhealthy foods: sweets and chocolates, sweets and chocolates, fatty foods, fizzy drinks, cakes. These are unhealthy for our health. These things will destroy our health. So we have to avoid eating unhealthy foods. See this, these are junk varieties, junk food varieties: chips, candy, soft drinks, jam, chocolates, cookies, cake, sugar, butter, fried fast food. These things are junk foods. We have to avoid eating more junk foods because it will destroy our good health. So we have to avoid eating more junk foods. We have to start eating good and healthy green and vegetables, fruits and vegetables more. Shall we see the advantages of healthy food? Yes, it keeps you healthy. Eating healthy foods will keep you healthy. It gives you more energy to carry on. So it will give you more energy to live longer. You will live longer. So you will live longer for eating healthy food. If you eat healthy foods more, you will live longer. You will save money. You will also save money of eating healthy food because eating healthy vegetables and fruits are, you can save money because these things are very cheap and low money. Now we will see some disadvantages of unhealthy food. We have to read about the disadvantages of unhealthy food. There are addictive ingredients such as sugar, oil, butter and so on. So these addictive ingredients will be added in unhealthy foods. You will become overweight. If you eating more unhealthy junk foods, you will be become overweight. Some are expensive. Some unhealthy foods like pizza, burger, these things are unhealthy for our health and also these things are very expensive. You won't be healthy. If you eating all these things, you won't be healthy person. So you have to avoid eating unhealthy food. So children, you should avoid eating fast food like junk foods and unhealthy foods. And you should start eating healthy green vegetables and green fruits.
Children,
Now we are going to do an interesting activity of circling the healthy food and crossing the unhealthy food. See this one. Yes, this is a healthy food. Is this healthy or unhealthy? This is also a healthy, but eating over chicken, it is unhealthy for our health. So see this one. So the salads are also good for our health. So the burger is not good for our health. So this is unhealthy food. The chocolates also unhealthy. Orange, yes, it is good for our health. Cheese roll, no, this is not good for our health. Soup, yes, this soup is good for our health. So this egg is good for our health. Yes, this one is also healthy food. Bread is also a healthy food. And see the banana also a healthy food. The cup ice cream is not good for our health, so we have to cross it out. And this cup of salads are good for our health. And see the rice. Yes, this one also good for our health. Okay, for your activity, you have to draw and color any or some healthy and unhealthy foods in A4 sheet.
Did you all enjoy the activity, children? Yes. Let us see the result, okay? Salman was a young boy. So this story is all about a young boy. His name is Salman. Salman was a young boy who did not like to eat his food. So Salman did not like to eat his food properly. So he refused to eat his meals every day. In the morning, he refused to eat his food. In the morning, we eat breakfast, isn't it? So in the morning, he refused to eat his breakfast. In the afternoon, we eat lunch. Okay? So in the afternoon, we eat lunch. Salman refused to eat his lunch. And he threw away his lunch into the dustbin. In the night, we eat dinner. In the night, we eat dinner. Salman hid under his bed. Salman would hide under in his bed. So in the morning, he refused to eat. In the afternoon, he would throw away his lunch into the dustbin. In the night, he would hide under his bed. So he always refused to eat his three meals. He did not like to eat his food properly. His mother, Salman's mother, was worried that he was becoming weak day by day. Salman's mother was worried about Salman because Salman was becoming weak day by day. Because why he is weak day by day? Because Salman did not eat his food properly. He refused to eat his three meals. Every day he refused to eat. So in the morning he refused to eat. In the afternoon he would throw away his lunch into the dustbin. In the night, he hid under his bed. So he refused to eat. That's why he is becoming weak day by day. He felt sick. Who felt sick? Salman felt sick. He was in bed for many days. He was in bed because he is sick. He was in bed for many days. As days passed, his feeling of loneliness grew. His feeling of loneliness grew because he stayed at home for many days because he was sick. So here grew is the past tense of grow. Okay? Salman was sick. He was in bed for many days. One fine morning, he suddenly saw a pink queen outside his potato. See this? The penguin was eating a sandwich. What the penguin is doing? The penguin is eating a tasty sandwich. The penguin pushed a plate of sandwich to Salmon and left. So this penguin placed a plate of sandwich to Salmon and left the place, and he went away from the place. Salmon was very surprised. Salmon was very surprised to see the penguin, and the penguin pushed a plate of sandwich to Salmon. He ate the sandwich. He was very surprised and he thought that it was a dream. And he saw the sandwich, then he ate all the sandwich. Then only he realized that it was not a dream, it is real sandwich. It is a real sandwich. Salmon was very surprised and he ate the sandwich. In the morning, the penguin gave a plate of sandwich to Salmon. So he ate the sandwich in the morning. See, that same afternoon, a monkey came with a food tray. Who came with the food tray? Yes, see the picture? A monkey came with the food tray. It had brought soup and fried rice for his lunch. The monkey brought soup and hot fried rice for Salmon for his lunch. The monkey placed the tray and left. The monkey also placed the food tray and he went away from the place. Salmon drank the soup and ate the fried rice. In the afternoon, Salmon drank the soup and the hot fried rice. In the morning, the penguin gave a plate of sandwich to Salmon. In the afternoon, a monkey placed a tray of soup and sandwich. In the morning, Salmon ate the sandwich. In the afternoon, he ate the hot soup and the fried rice. So, in the next class, we will see what happened and who will give the dinner for Salmon. Okay? So, in the next class, we will see.
Salmon was a young boy who did not like to eat his food. In the morning, he refused to have his breakfast. In the afternoon, he would throw away his lunch into the dustbin. During dinner time, he would hide under his bed and refuse to have dinner. He fell sick and was in bed for many days. One morning, he saw a penguin outside his bedroom window. The penguin placed a plate of sandwich by the window and left. Salmon was very surprised. In the afternoon, he saw a monkey place a food tray of soup and fried rice for his lunch by the window. Salmon drank the soup and ate the fried rice.
Children, did you all enjoy this story? It's very good. In the next class, we'll see you who gave the dinner. Okay? In the next class, we will see. Now, we'll see the adverbs of this lesson. First one, refuse. R-E-F-U-S-E. Refuse. Refuse means deny. D-E-N-Y. Deny. Sick. S-I-C-K. Sick. Sick means ill. I-L-L. Ill. Worried. See? W-O-R-R-I-E-D. Worried. Worried means sad or upset. See the word? Sad or upset. Lonely. L-O-N-E-L-Y. Lonely. Lonely means alone. Feeling alone. A-L-O-N-E. Alone. Gently. G-E-N-T-L-Y. Gently. Slowly. S-L-O-W-L-Y. Slowly. Weak. W-E-A-K. Weak. Weak means not strong. N-O-T. Not strong. S-T-R-O-N-G. Strong. Not strong enough. That means weak. So, refuse means
are going to write the class work. Take your English class work and sharp your pens. Okay, now we are going to write the lesson number 3. The name of the lesson is A Meal. A meal. D D E A L. D. A meal. D. First we are going to write Roman letter 1. In Roman letter 1 we are going to write D words. D words. Okay. So the first one is costume. See, the first letter must be in cursive capital letter. Okay. C O S T U M E S. Costumes. Second one, worried. W O R R I D. What's the word? Worried. Third one, plate. P L A T E. Plate. Fourth one is noise. N O I S E. Noise. Fifth one is gently. G E N T L Y. Gently. So this is how you have to write your D words. Sixth one, refuse. R E F U S E D. Refused. And for the seventh one, here I don't have enough space to write the seventh, eighth, ninth and tenth one. So I have turned the next page. The seventh one is lonely. L O N E L I N E. Yes, yes. Loneliness. Loneliness means feeling alone. Eighth one, surprise. Yes. U R P R I S E. Surprise. Ninth one, ill. Or ill means sick. Okay. Tenth one, wander. W O N D R E D. So now we have written the 10 D words. First one, costumes. Second one, worried. Third one, plate. Fourth one, noise. Fifth one, gently. Sixth one, refused. Seventh one, loneliness. Eighth one, surprise. Ninth one, sick. And the tenth one, wandered. Now we are going to write Roman letter 2. Synonyms. Synonyms. So the first word is refuse. R E F U S E. Refuse. Refuse means deny. Second one, sick. Meaning for sick is ill. Third one, worried. Worried means sad or upset. Lonely. Lonely means alone. Fifth one, gently. Gently means slowly. So these are the five synonyms in the third lesson. See, refuse. Refuse means deny. Sick, ill, worried, sad, lonely, alone, gently, slowly. Now we'll move on to antonyms. So for antonyms, turn the next page and write. Roman letter 3. Antonyms. First one, strong. S T R O N G. Strong. Opposite of strong is weak. Second one, good. Opposite of good is bad. Third one, colorful. Opposite of colorful is colorless. Fourth one, early. Early, the opposite of early is late. Fifth one, cold. Opposite of cold is hot. So for your home assignment, you have to write down the keywords, synonyms and antonyms in your English classwork notebook. There are five antonyms in the third lesson. First one is strong. Opposite of strong is weak. Good. Opposite of good is bad. Colorful. Opposite of colorful is colorless. Early. Opposite of early is late. Cold. Opposite of cold is hot.
Children, now it's time for your home assignment. For your home assignment, you have to write down the keywords, synonyms and antonyms. You have to write these things in your English classwork notebook. So have to write down synonyms, antonyms and finally keywords in your classwork. And for your activity, you have one more activity. You have to do it in A4 sheet. Okay? Draw and color some healthy and junk foods. You have to draw and color some healthy and junk foods in A4 sheet. Okay? For an activity, you have to do this. And for your home assignment, you have to write these things in your classwork notebook. Hope you enjoy this class, children. We meet you next.